The move comes against the backdrop of a recent enactment of the GMO law in neighboring Kenya, legalizing the introduction of GMOs in the country.
There's a lot that has been going on in terms of trade within these two countries, but also with the liberalization of trade within the East African community. That means each one of us within the East African community is at liberty to trade and participate in trade exportation and importation of agricultural products and any other products.
Food rights experts under the umbrella body of Pelham Uganda insist that Ugandans need to reject any plans to introduce GMOs in the country, saying that GMOs pose health risks as well as a danger to the environment.
We stand and still maintain that our stand is no to GMOs. And why we are saying this is because of the impact of GMOs in terms of seed sovereignty, in terms of trade, and in terms of the impact it will have in terms of dependency on the GMO manufacturers and the people that are benefiting from the GMO trade.
They are instead advocating consuming natural indigenous food.
We believe in biodiversity, we believe in synergy building, we believe in harnessing our indigenous knowledge and heritage.
John Ludonkol, the Assistant Commissioner of Crop Production in the Ministry of Agriculture, explained why the government is still dragging its feet to pass the GMO bill into law.
Uganda has GMO crops. For example, we have maize, bananas, cassava, cotton, and other products. But this cannot be released because the Katagana Protocol is not there.
Pelham Uganda has now partnered with other organizations to amplify the voices of all agroecology actors through unlocking barriers for scaling up agroecology in the country.
What the GMOs will have on the beneficial insects when it comes to pollination, in terms of what it will have to our human health and the health of the animals that will be consuming the GMOs.
We want to bring out the farmers' voices on how farmers have used agroecology for climate resilience. And this will also be in tandem with Corifan Academy, who will bring in the scientific view, such papers that have been developed in relation to agroecology for climate resilience.
Story by Juliet Namuaya for the news.